guys, welcome to another session of Learning with Prep Class. I am BC, I am a Prep Class tutor. In this video, I'll be solving question 15 to question 20 of the Loyola JC College Entrance Examination Mathematics Paper 5. Subscribe to this channel to get more videos like this that will help you in preparation for your entrance examination. Okay? Alright, so let's begin. Question 15. If the price of chairs decreased from 460 naira last year to 40 naira, calculate the percentage decrease. Okay, so first of all, what is the old price? So it decreased from 460 naira. So this means that 460 naira is the old price. So the old price is 460 naira. Then it decreased from 460 naira to 40 naira. Okay, so the new price is 40 naira. Wow, that decrease is very high. Okay, so it decreased to 40 naira. So the new price is 40 naira. Then we are asked to calculate the percentage decrease. Before we can calculate the percentage decrease, we need to know the decrease in price first. Decrease in price is old price minus new price. The old price is 460 naira. Then the new price is 40 naira. So we have 460 naira minus 40 naira. And we can do that here. 0 minus 0 is 0. 6 minus 4 is 2. 4 minus nothing is 4. So we have 420 naira as the decrease in price. So now we can go ahead and find the percentage decrease. Percentage decrease is decrease in price divided by old price multiplied by 100. The decrease in price is 420 naira. Then the old price is 460 naira. So we have 420 naira divided by 460 naira multiplied by 100. Okay, so 420 naira multiplied by 100 is 42,000 naira divided by 460 naira. Naira cancels naira, then 0 cancels 0. So now we are left with 4,200 divided by 46, and that can be done here using the long division method. Okay, so we have to find the first possible digit that is divisible by 46. 4 is not divisible by 46, 42 is not divisible by 46, but 420 is divisible by 46. So 420 divided by 46 is 9. 9 times 46 is 414. 420 minus 414 is 6. Then 6 is not divisible by 46, so we have to drop down the next digit, which is 0. So we have 60 now. 60 divided by 46 is 1. 1 times 46 is 46. 16 minus 46 is 14. 14 is not divisible by 46, and there are no more digits to drop down. So this is what we do. We put a decimal point here, and we add 0 to this. So now we have 140. 140 divided by 46 is 3. 3 times 46 is 138. 140 minus 138 is 2. Okay, so this division will go on and on. So that's why we have to stop it there. Okay, so we have 91.3. So 4,200 divided by 46 is 91.3. So the percentage decrease is 91.3%. Okay, so that's the answer. So the correct option here is option C, 91.3. Check. Question 16. Evaluate square root of 441. Okay, so this is very easy. So to find the square root of 441, we can use the prime factorization method. Okay, so the prime factorization method is one of the many methods of finding the square root of a number. So in this video, I'll be using the prime factorization method. The first step is to reduce 441 to its prime factors. Okay, so 441 divided by 3 is 147. 147 divided by 3 is 49. 49 divided by 7 is 7. 7 divided by 7 is 1. So here are the prime factors of 441. So the square root of 441 is equal to the square root of 3 times 3 times 7 times 7. Now, step 2 is to group the digits in pairs. Write only one of each pair and multiply. So we can put 3, 3 as a pair, then 7 times 7 as a pair as well. Okay, then we write only one of each pair. Okay, so we write 3 and 7. So 3 multiplied by 7 is 21. So the square root of 441 is 21. How do you know if the answer is correct? All you have to do is to multiply 21 by itself. If you get 441, then that's the answer. So when we multiply 21 by itself, we get 441. So the correct answer is 21. The square root of 441 is 21. So the correct option here is option C. Check. Question 17. Divide 614,400 by 640. So we are going to be using the long division method to do this. It's very easy. The first thing is to find out the first possible digit that is divisible by 640, and that is 6,144. 6,144 divided by 640 is 9. 9 times 640 is 5,760. 4 minus 0 is 4. 4 minus 6 is not possible, so we get 1 from the next digit, which is 1, and it remains 0. Put the 1 here, it becomes 14. 14 minus 6 is 8. Then this is now 0. 0 minus 7 is not possible, so we get 1 from 6. It remains 5. Put the 1 here, it becomes 10. 10 minus 7 is 3. So we now have 384. 384 is not divisible by 640. So we drop down the next digit, which is 0, and it becomes 3,840. 3,840 divided by 640 is 6. 6 times 640 is 3,840. 3,840 minus 3,840 is 0. But we still have one more digit, which is 0. So let's drop it down. 0 divided by 640 is 0. So this means that we've been able to completely divide 614,400 by 640. Okay, so the answer is 960. Okay, so the correct option here is option C, 960. Check. Question 18. 14 contractors can finish a piece of work in 448 hours. How many hours will it take 56 contractors to complete the same work if they work at the same rate? Okay, so this is very easy. So we have to bring out the information one after the other. 14 contractors can finish a piece of work in 448 days. Now, how many hours will it take 56 contractors to complete the same work if they work at the same rate? So first of all, we need to find the rate, okay? Now, when the number of contractors increase, the time taken to complete the work will decrease. Now, 14 contractors take 448 hours. So now that 56 contractors are going to do the same job at the same rate, they're going to take lesser time because there are more contractors. Okay, so when the number of contractors increase, the time taken to complete the work will decrease. So this means that the number of contractors is inversely proportional to the number of hours. What does inverse proportion mean? Inverse proportion occurs when one value decreases and the other increases, or when one value increases and the other decreases. Okay, so since they work at the same rate now, we are going to use the formula T equals K over N. T is time, that's the number of hours. K is the constant of proportionality, that is the rate, okay? Now, N is the number of contractors, okay? So now, the first part of the question says, 14 contractors can finish a piece of work in 448 hours, okay? So that means that T is 448 hours, N is 14 contractors. Now, we want to find the rate at which they are working for us to be able to find out how many hours which is 6 contractors will take to finish the work. Okay, so now we have 448 equals K over 14. So to make K the subject of the formula, we cross multiply. So we have K equals 448 multiplied by 14. And that can be done here. 4 times 8 is 32, write 2, carry 3. 4 times 4 is 16. 16 plus 3 is 19, write 9, carry 1. 4 times 4 is 16. 16 plus 1 is 17. 1 times 8 is 8. 1 times 4 is 4. 1 times 4 is 4. So now let's add it together. 2 plus nothing is 2. 9 plus 8 is 17. Write 7, carry 1. 1 plus 7 is 8. 8 plus 4 is 12. Write 2, carry 1. 1 plus 1 is 2. 2 plus 4 is 6. So 448 multiplied by 14 is 6,272. So now we've been able to find the rate at which they are working. So now the 56 contractors will work at the same rate. So how many hours will it take? So now we already know that the rate is 6,272. Then the number of contractors now is 56 contractors. Okay, so now we use the same formula, T equals K over N, for us to be able to find out how many hours it will take 56 contractors to finish the same work at the same rate. T equals 6,272 divided by 56. And that can be done here. 62 divided by 56 is 1. 1 times 56 is 56. 62 minus 56 is 6. 6 is not divisible by 56, so we drop down the next digit, which is 7. So now we have 67. 67 divided by 56 is 1. 1 times 56 is 56. 7 minus 6 is 1. 6 minus 5 is 1. So we have 11. 11 is not divisible by 56. 11 is not divisible by 56, so we drop down the next digit, which is 2. So now we have 112. 112 divided by 56 is 2. 2 times 56 is 112. 112 minus 112 is 0. So we've been able to completely divide 6,272 by 56, and that is 112. So this means that it will take 56 contractors 112 hours to finish the same piece of work at the same rate. So can you see now that the higher the number of contractors, the lesser the time? Can you see that? 14 contractors take 448 hours to complete the job. Now that there are 56 contractors, they will take 112 hours. So they take less hours because there are more contractors. So the answer is 112 hours. So the correct option here is option A, 112 hours. Check. Question 19. A square field has an area of 4,356 meters squared. What is the length of one side of the square field? Okay, so this is very easy. So the area of a square is A square, where A is length of one side. But in this question, we are given the area of the square already. Okay, now we are asked to find the length of one side of the square field. Okay, so the area of the square field is 4,356 meters squared equals A square. Okay, so to make A the subject of the formula, we have to find the square root of 4,356 meters squared. Okay, so let's find the square root of 4,356. We've done square root earlier, so I hope you still remember the steps. So that's what we're going to do here again. So to find the square root of 4,356, using the prime factorization method, the first step is to reduce 4,356 to its prime factors. So 4,356 divided by 2 is 2,178. 2,178 divided by 2 is 1,089. 1,089 divided by 3 is 363. 363 divided by 3 is 121. 121 divided by 11 is 11. 11 divided by 11 is 1. So the square root of 4,356 is now square root of 2 times 2 times 3 times 3 times 11 times 11. Okay, so now the second step is to group the digits in pairs. Write only one of each pair and multiply. So now we have to put the digits in pairs, that is in twos. Okay, so 2 times 2 in one pair, 3 times 3 in one pair, 11 times 11 in one pair. Then write only one of each pair, that is 2, 3, and 11. Then multiply. 2 times 3 is 6, 6 times 11 is 66. So this means that the square root of 4,356 is 66. To know if the answer is correct, multiply 66 by itself, that is, find the square of 66. 66 times 66, that will give you 4,356. So that means that it's correct. So A is 66 meters. And remember that A is the length of one side of the square. So the length of one side of the square field is 66 meters. So the correct option here is option A, 66 meters. Check. Now to the final question in this video, question 20. Evaluate 6,396.54 minus 5,407.39. Okay, so this is actually very easy as well. So it's just the basic subtraction. So arrange the numbers on top of each other and subtract. Okay, so let's start. 4 minus 9 is not possible. So we get 1 from 5. It remains 4. Put the 1 here, it becomes 14. 14 minus 9 is 5. 4 minus 3 is 1. Then put the decimal point. Then 6 minus 7 is not possible. So get 1 from 9 and it remains 8. Put the 1 here, it becomes 16. 16 minus 7 is 9. 8 minus 0 is 8. 3 minus 4 is not possible. So get 1 from 6, it remains 5. Put the 1 here, it becomes 13. 13 minus 4 is 9. Then 5 minus 5 is 0. Okay? So we don't write it. So we have 989.15. Okay? So 6,396.54 minus 5,407.39 is 989.15. So the correct option is option D. 989.15. Check. I hope you enjoyed this video and you've been able to learn a lot. So if you enjoyed this video, please make sure that you like and comment on this video, and also subscribe to this channel to get more videos like this. You can join us on WhatsApp by clicking on the link in the description below. Till I come your way next time. Bye.